So these are all, high-tech welding. So anybody who is interested academically can study this. From examination point of view, it is of less importance. Now, in explosive welding, even the plates as large as 6 meter by 2 meters have been joined. So, as the name suggests, the explosion is a kind of a explosion. There is an impact. So that impact will interlocks the two surface so that by pressure, applying pressure and by plastic deformation, the welding will take place. So there is a flyer plate which is placed at an angle. Then the advantage of explosive is that the bond strength is very high and the explosive. It is made up of plastic sheet most of the times. There is something called the detonation speed. And that speed is it is in the range of this much, 2400 to 3600. And there is a constraint on minimum speed also. See, this is what I was selling. The 6 by 2 meters have been explosive welded. Why it is not so popular? Because it is dangerous, explosive welding. It is not safe. But it is very, very fast. Then you have another welding process, that is from the examination point of view, you are submerged arc welding, then TIG, MIG, these are very important. Then diffusion weldings, it is so as the name suggests, it occurs because of the diffusion. Diffusion means that is movement of atoms across the interface. The parameters on which the diffusion welding depends, they are the pressure, temperature, then the time of contact, and the how clean the surfaces are. The biggest advantage of diffusion welding is that it is suitable for joining dissimilar metals. Why? Because diffusion involves migration of the atoms across the joint. And because of this process is the slowest process. But it is accurate, and that's why. Wherever the quantity is less, wherever it is no mass production, and accuracy is important, like aerospace, nuclear, electronic industries. So there, diffusion welding is popular. This is how the process of diffusion welding is. The sequence is from left to right, A, B, and C. This is a diffusion welding setup for lab join. The diagram which is shown here, that is for the ultrasonic welding. And in ultrasonic welding, the welding takes place because of the vibration and the pressure. And in order to get the desired vibration, we use transducer here. This is ultrasonic welding, which is used for seam welding. Seam welding is nothing but which runs for a longer run. Ultrasonic welding is also called as the USW. Thermochemical welding is important from examination point of view, and it is popular where the electricity is not available. So in this you have two type. Thermite welding and atomic hydrogen welding. So from examination point of view, thermite welding is important. AHW is short form for atomic hydrogen welding. So here an arc is generated between two tungsten electrodes. These are the two tungsten electrodes. And this is done under the protection of hydrogen gas. So advantage is very high heat concentration. Then there is a shielding of hydrogen. This is a thermite welding. The chemical reaction you must know, and you must write this whenever the question is asked. This is the reduction process. Reduction means removal of oxygen. Oxidation means addition of oxygen. So in this process, iron oxide, that is Fe3O4, is reduced to thermite steel, that is Fe. Fe is called as an iron, which is called as a thermite steel, plus aluminum oxide, that is called as a slag, and lot of heat is generated. So this reaction is important. So it's a balanced reaction, that is 8Al plus 3Fe3O4, that gives rise to 9Fe plus 4Al2O3 plus heat. The temperature of 3000 degree Celsius is almost produced. Now this is the setup for thermite welding. Just have a close look. This is a mixture, thermite mixture. Now section BB, if you take section, this is the mold. If you take a section AB, so you will see like this. So you can say this is your left hand view and this is your front view. And these are the two parts which are to be joined. So I am showing you this diagram properly. These are the two parts. So this is important from examination point of view. These are the two parts which are to be welded. So if you see from here, side view, so the part will be seen like this. Part will look like this.
Sir, ये wax pattern का मतलब क्या सर?
Wax pattern. Now this is what is going to be melted. Okay. And in this, now they see wax pattern. This is used for creating this mold. बराबर है? This is a sand. Now when you pour a molten metal from here, this wax being low melting point, having low melting point, it will melt. And the molten metal will take this place. It will mix with the wax and then it will join these two parts. So wax pattern is nothing but in this much place molten metal will go, in this much space wax will melt, and there is a sand surrounding this wax pattern. Clear it is? Hello?
Yes.
नहीं समझा?
नहीं नहीं समझा.
समझा ना? हाँ. This is how thermite welding is done on site. Especially, it is used for welding the tracks. Railway tracks. This is how it is welded, cracks or broken rails. And of course, they are finished by grinding later on, once the welding is completed. So that was important, thermite welding from examination point of view. Then another type is radiation welding, in which you have electron beam welding and laser beam welding. That is EBW and LBW. So these are all sophisticated welding processes. As you know, now here is a source of electrons, that is a filament which is heated, from which the electrons are generated, and this is like your normal CRT tube, what you have studied in physics, and then electrons, they are focused on a workpiece. You have a focusing lens, you have a positioning diaphragm, so that electron can be focused at a particular point. So the principle remains same like electron beam machining. So in electron beam welding, heat is generated due to the high beam electrons. Then this kinetic energy is converted into heat, which will melt the workpiece which is to be joined. And remember, this is normally done in vacuum where there is no oxygen. So higher the vacuum, the more the electron beam will penetrate, and better is the weld. It can be done in no vacuum condition also, but then the quality will be compromised. The advantage of this electron beam welding is you can do very welding of very small pieces like foil of 0.1 thickness can also be welded. Another biggest advantage is that you can EW any material can be electron beam welded. The quality is very good. These are the applications: aircraft, missile, nuclear, electronic component. So you may be aware that how small the electronic components are, that is diode, transistor, ICs. Same is the procedure for LBW. LBW is nothing but laser beam welding. Instead of electron beam, here laser beam is used to melt, and you know the energy generated by the laser beam. So a laser beam is used for melting. Again, laser welding can be, or it is popular also, laser welding, because whatever we discuss, explosive bolo, ultrasonic bolo, diffusion bolo, electron beam, these are all very costly processes and can be afforded by very big organizations like IITs, TIFR, BRC. Commercially, like suppose if you have a welding workshop, you cannot afford. So for that, laser welding is the solution. Laser welding, like suppose if you want to weld a small GI sheet, small patra, 18 gauge bolo, ya 20 gauge, ya 22 gauge, cupboard ka patra. So there, arc welding will fail. It will melt the entire material. So in that case, laser welding is the answer. So even though the laser sources are imported, still now other cost or other equipment, that is equipment, laser machine, entire laser machine can be manufactured in India except source. So the cost is within control. Still, if you want to go for laser welding, say of 2 kilowatt, it is designated, the important parameter is heat. 2 kilowatt ka laser if you want to go, then, and of course the size 3 meter by 3 meter, then it will not cost you less than 65 lakhs. So for very delicate and small metals, laser beam welding is preferred. This is what the diagram is. Almost the same diagram is for laser beam machining also. So we were discussing welding processes. So wherever the material to be welded is, say, thick or heavy cross-sectional area, where the strength is required, then we go for welding. Where the thickness of the metal to be welded is less, there we can't go for welding, because the base metal which is to be welded will not withstand the temperature. So there we go for brazing. And if the material is very thin, like wires, ICs, diode, transistor, then we go for soldering. So welding bolo, brazing bolo, soldering bolo, all three are joining processes. It joins two metals or two pieces. So this is the diagram for brazing. You have base metal, two base metal, and in between two base metal, with the help of a torch, you are filling the filler metal. And have flux to protect it from atmosphere. So basically we use brazing for repair work. Also we use this for dissimilar metals, because actually it's not a fusion welding. The base metal is not melted. You are filling it with the, that is the joint is filled with filler material. But the strength of the brazing is better than soldering. These are the filler metals which are used for brazing. So if your base metal, that is metal to be brazed, is aluminium, then filler metal is this aluminium silicon, and the temperature is this, and so on. Like ferrous and non-ferrous. Then we use silver rod, and these are all filler metal is very expensive. Silver rod, gold, nickel, silver. These are all very expensive material. So where you can get the returns, where you can get the money, there only, or where it is very important, there only you have to go for this silver rods. Again, the strength and the adhesiveness depends upon many factors, like what is the clearance between joint, how much is the joint area, what is the nature of the bond, and so on. Like here now, the effect of joint clearance on the joint strength is shown. Like if the joint clearance is more, up to certain clearance, the strength is increased, and then thereafter tensile strength and shear strength will decrease, as well as joint strength. Again, you have to maintain a proper clearance. Now, how breathing can be done? So, breathing can be done by torch, which is very common. Or you can do breathing in furnace also, which is called as the furnace breathing. Why it is called as a furnace breathing? Because furnace is used to heat the workpiece, which are to be joined by breathing operation. So here the component parts and brazing metal, they are loaded into a furnace. Then they are heated to a brazing temperature, and then they are cooled and removed. Now here filler material is nothing but a shaped wire. Note that the filler material is a shaped wire. So this is breathe before and this is after breathing. Like say this is a filler material and the filler material goes like this. And this is how it gets braised. So one is by default it is torch braising. Second method is furnace braising, and then third is induction braising. Processes are basically classified as per the heat produced. So in one case, heat is produced by gas, that is in torch. In furnace, it can be, most of the time it is electrically heated. Induction braising, it is working on the principle of eddy currents, that is back EMF. And torch braising you can study for examination. Again, further classifications are resistance brazing, that is the heat is applied to melt the filler metal due to resistance to the flow of electric current. That's why the name is resistance brazing. Then deep brazing means heating of the joint is done by dipping it into the molten salt bath, which is at a high temperature. So deep brazing may we are using a molten metal bath. In which the component is dipped. Infrared brazing. Here the infrared lamps are used for heating and which can generate heat up to 5 kilowatts. The heavy brazing is called as the braze welding. So braze welding is nothing but it is a trade-off between welding and brazing. So temperatures higher than 600 but lower than 800. So that is your braze welding. So if you need to have a stronger joint, then you need to go for larger contact area. And here are some drawings where it is shown how the different pieces can be assembled and braced. Like here, you have additional contact area. So this is a good design for brazing. Now soldering is again same as brazing, but the temperature is low. Generally it is in the range of 300 degrees Celsius and never more than 450 degrees Celsius. So filler metal which is used here is called as the solder. And these are the types of the solders and their applications. Layered tin. This is used as a general purpose solder. Then tin zinc. This is for the aluminium. And so on. Wave soldering is popular in electronic industries. Like you might have seen PCB, that is printed circuit board, which is used in electronic industries, on which you are say soldering different components, resistors, diode, transistors, so many components. Now there are many printed circuit boards which has to be soldered in mass quantity, in mass production. So there we are not using a soldering gun to do the solder. A component we don't solder by gun, because if you like this, suppose if you want to make one PCB, it will take half an hour, and we are talking about 300-400 PCBs in 8 hours or still less. So here the components are mounted in the first step on the PCB components. There are in the PCB the tracks, the contact tracks are already cut, and there are holes in which the registered capacitors, diodes, transistors, ICs are drilled. So in these holes, all these components are mounted in the step one. And then in the next step, this printed circuit board are passed over a wave of solder. And this machine is called the wave soldering machine. Wave soldering machine, where a wave of solder is passed, like when you are going to beach and we see the wave coming in front of us. So similarly, a wave of solder is passed over printed circuit board and the components get soldered. So it's very rapid, very fast. In 1 second, all the components get soldered due to the wave. And this technique is also called as the SMT. That is nothing but surface mount technology. SMT is nothing but surface mount technology, which is a technique we use for electronic industries, that is in PCB. This is what is shown in this diagram. Here some explanation is also given, which you can read. A PCB on which electronic components have been placed with their lead wires extending to the holes in the board is loaded onto a conveyor for transfer through the wave soldering. Matlab PCBs, they'll keep on moving on a moving conveyor, okay, and the wave of solder will also keep on moving, and all the PCBs will get soldered, and the production rates are very high. As said, soldering joint is weak. This is SEM, that is scanning electron microscope. SEM stands for SEM image of bare solder joint on surface mount device. This is what I was talking, SMT, that is surface mount technology. So SMT machine ke upar, not HMT, SMT, the PCBs are soldered, and this is the image of the joint. So soldering joint are weak joint, but they are not very weak, means you can reasonably pull the wires and it will not come out. Of course you cannot apply very high force, because as you know, in electronic industries the soldering is used just to make the contacts, just to pass the voltage, electric current. There are no tension force or compressive force or shear force. It is not subjected to any forces. It is just acts as a connective media. That is, jo wire hai, has to remain there reasonably for longer time, and the current has to pass. There are no forces. Reflow soldering is not used, so you can skip that. This figure these are the joints which are commonly used for the soldering. Now if you note here, this E, then G, here you can see that these are, before soldering, these are mechanically joined. That is, you are using bolt so that it can remain in a position, and then soldering is done. That is what is called as the mechanically joined. And then you can remove this bolt or rivet after soldering. But then you have to take permission that whether this bolt or rivet can be used or not. You have to take permission from the designer, product designer. If it is aesthetically important, or if the assembly doesn't allow this hole, then you have to think of something else. Maybe you can use a clamp, C clamp, to hold the two pieces together and then go for the soldering. But if the product designer allows a hole in this, that is in these two plates, then definitely you can make use of, you can take advantage of that. here are the differences between welding, brazing, soldering. So welding is the strongest and brazing is in between. So in terms of temperature, then melting point, here the workpieces are melted. See, welding is the strongest, brazing is little less stronger, and soldering is the weakest. Temperatures are more in welding, 3800 degrees Celsius. So here the base metal or workpiece, they are melted. In brazing, workpieces are heated, but they are not melted. And in soldering, absolutely the workpieces are not heated, because if you heat that diode, triode, ICs, you will not get anything. The component will disappear. Now in welding, regular welding, since there is a heating and cooling, so there are microstructural changes happening, and therefore mechanical properties of the base metal will change due to this process, which is called as the heat treatment. In soldering, there is absolutely no change in mechanical properties, because there is no heating, cooling. There is no heat treatment. Brazing is in between. It may change, but most of the time, it doesn't change. Because the temperature required for the heat treatment, we don't reach in brazing. So that's why changes in the mechanical properties are not much in brazing. Soldering, the skill requirement and cost requirement is less. Welding, both are high, especially welding when you do vertical welding, or if you want to do welding on the ceiling, it's a tough job. And that's why welders, हम लोग बोलते हैं 6G वेल्डिंग और वर्टिकल वेल्डर्स, हॉरिजॉन्टल वेल्डर्स, दे आर इन ग्रेट डिमांड. सिंस हीट ट्रीटमेंट, वी सी हीट ट्रीटमेंट, दैट इज हीटिंग एंड कूलिंग इन वेल्डिंग, सो वी नीड टू, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस हीटिंग एंड कूलिंग द स्ट्रेसेस आर डेवलप. एंड इन ऑर्डर टू रिमूव दिस स्ट्रेसेस, वी हैव टू डू operations like stress relieving. So stress relieving is a type of heat treatment. In heat treatment, there are different processes like annealing, normalizing, stress relieving, tempering, hardening. So many processes are there. These processes depends upon how you heat and how you cool the components. So heat treatment is not only, doesn't mean it's only hardening. In heat treatment, you can soften the material, you can temper the material, you can harden the material, anything. So that's why it's very artistic or very beautiful process to learn. You change the cooling rates and you get the different microstructure, and you get the different properties at the end. So because of the welding, the stresses involved are high, and heat treatment is required to remove the stresses, otherwise it will lead to the cracks. Generally the preheating is not required for welding, because in welding itself it's get heated. And in brazing and soldering, a little preheating gives you good result. Okay, so this weld defects and this thing, that will continue in the next class. So, thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, welcome.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.